Tsar Joseph seat up close once a few years back. But I wouldn't give you a back in time and this shit right now.
See that? That's his calling card. Innocent people burned alive. Goddamn cults grabbing everyone. They'll take you from your home, bar, even church. Don't matter where you are. Then they slot you into one of two categories. Weak or strong. See, Jacob's building an army. And anyone who can't or won't fight for him winds up dead. Culling the herd, he calls it. Wholesale slaughter innocent people. Nobody believed it was happening, because nobody wanted to believe.
I've heard a lot of fucked up things are happening in these mountains. Getting a better angle. Some trouble ahead.
Jesus!
You got to the spot! Good ass dead!
Alive!
Bullseye. Well, still breathing. Cats always bite. I don't trust that thing.
And then there's the one we're after.
Andy Port in a storm.
He's one of Jacob's favorites. The one who leads his purging. But the cook's bought into all of Jacob's bullshit. This motherfucker's gonna get what he deserves. All right, almost there.
Could have been better.
Only I had my back.
Come on, I need.
Thank you. Thank you. For
the
real.
The cook.
There's more
he
of us. The cook.
Please do
something. Oh, God.
But there were others. They picked them up the mountain.
Okay, let's get moving.
Peaches, you want to know why they call him the cook?
A couple years back. Jacob sent one of his guys out to round up his family.
Parents and kids. First thing he did was starve them.
Wherever you want.
Nothing. Not even a drop of water. After 3 days, they got so thirsty they had to drink their own piss. But the kids didn't want to do it. So the parents forced it down their throats. The kids puked it right back up. Cook didn't like that. He went and strung the parents up on posts under the hot sun. Hold up. I think I heard something.
Jacob Seed runs the show out here. He's built up an army.
Not a good spot.
Let's look at what's going on. We're gonna execute him. Take point. I got your back. Remember, if they spot us, those people are dead on sight.
Guess we're going loud.
Me out before you hadn't shown up. Who knows what would have happened.
Thank you. Oh, God. The cook took the rest of the pit.
Please don't leave me here.
Thank you for saving my ass.
Please help me. My husband. The cook took him to the pit. He's gonna burn him. He's gonna burn him alive.
What a bunch of assholes.
Sir, you're here to
excuse
help.
Me, sir.
Let's go.
Haven't felt like this since Afghanistan.
You're one of those deputies, aren't you?
So the cook. He had the parents on posts and decided to give the kids a little water. And then he asked. If they were hungry. Kids were starving, so they said yes. Started begging for food. Cook asked if they want pork. Kids said yes. So he went out to the parents and took their shoes off and started to play. This little piggy went to market. Blood poured like a damned faucet.
If Peaches swipes at me, I'm a tyrant.
Cook had a big old grin on his face as he offered each little piece to the kids. Sort of demon in the night. Anyways, that's why they call him the cook.
The cult trains their soldiers in the mountain. They got the hunt. Every little bit helps. Liberating some assets, huh?
You the cat. Thought I'd be happy. feeling now? Dutch was right. Cook's dead, and I don't feel anything. All I ever wanted was to find this guy. And now, I don't know what I'm supposed to do. Dutch has been right about a lot of shit lately. The cult, Eli, maybe he's right about you too. You need someone to watch your back? Call me. And, thanks for everything you've done. You had it rough.
Hey, deputy. That niece of mine. She don't make friends easy. But if you want things done quickly and quietly, she's your girl.
Quiet.
Keep her safe for me, okay?
Much time to remember.
She's been through a lot.
Glad we're on the same side, Grace.